While some people are busy being creative, others are being destructive. The demolition of old buildings is a natural part of the life cycle of any urban area. Old buildings make way for newer ones. The process of demolition can be very dangerous and often disrupts the lives of those who reside or work near the site. But a group of engineers at a Japanese construction company has come up with an innovative solution to make demolition go on virtually unnoticed. Let's take a look at their top-down approach.
This is, or rather was, the Akasaka Prince Hotel. Opened in 1985 when the Japanese economy was booming, this high-rise building was one of Tokyo's most famous landmarks, as well as a highly revered status symbol. But when visiting the site, we noticed that the building wasn't so high anymore. At this rate, it will probably be gone about a month later. The once 138-meter tall 40-story structure has slowly and quietly been shrinking without any traces of demolition work. The word demolition usually conjures up images of huge cranes and other heavy machinery, which cause significant environmental problems, including noise and heavy vibration, as well as dust and debris. But Taisei Corporation has found the solution. It's a demolition method called the TechoRep system, which gradually shrinks down buildings with minimum impact on the environment.
私たちはその超高層建物を解体するにあたって単に解体するという一つのやり方だけではなくてこの大きい建物が一つの資源であったりその建物を建て替えることによって町の再生だったり、まあ、そういうようなですねこの暮らしが豊かになるようなこの姿をぜひとも想像していきたいという願いからこの工法を開発しています。
From a world perspective,The longevity of most high-rise buildings is around 30 to 40 years. And Japan counts approximately 800 buildings taller than 100 meters, among which about 155 will probably be demolished in 10 years. Such an increase in the number of buildings to be torn down represents a business chance for large construction companies, and competition for developing new technology is fierce. The development of the TechoRep system began about 5 years ago. Currently, the usual method of demolition is from the top down. Large cranes gradually lower rubble and debris to the ground. However, for buildings more than 100 meters high, safety and space become major issues. To limit this problem, the concept for the TechoRep system was, from the beginning, to find a solution that would be quiet, practically invisible, and have very little impact on the environment. These conditions actually had long been requested by most of the company's clients in Japan.For buildings that were not originally built by Taisei Corporation, the process starts with the creation of digital data based on the building's floor maps.
構造図、意匠図というのはこう青焼きのですね、こう A1 サイズの冊子になってて、棚多分本棚一段分丸々あったぐらいな多分図面データがあったと思います。私どもの方で受注をさせていただいてから図面からこの CAD データを起こしてそして一つ一つこの図面をですねコンピューターに入れ込んでこのテコレップシステムでの手法というものを一つ一つ作っていったと思います。
The company uses a new kind of simulation system in the development stage to design the demolition process according to the specific building.
この工法で、実際に壊す、建物の状況が描かれています。これはすべて CAD データがきちんとこうレイヤーとなって描かれていて、このような3次元の画像に変換をしていくようにでもこのコントローラーを使ってあらゆるシチュエーションを見ることが可能になります。
Using the 3D model, the company is able to anticipate issues that might come up in the demolition process, thus dramatically increasing the levels of precision and safety of their new technology. Let's check out how it works. First, The floor to be demolished is encased in a special module consisting of soundproof panels and scaffolding. Debris is lowered down by a crane placed at the center of the module. Once the floor is completely taken apart, a computer-regulated system, which consists of jacks mounted inside temporary pillars, lowers the module to the floor below. The process is then repeated, and the building appears to slowly shrink until it's finally gone.
特徴としては、建物の最上階、この最上階の部分を蓋代わりにして、側面の部分を覆って、このようなキャップ構造をつけて、建物を上から帽子で覆って、その中で全ての解体工事をしてしまう。外には何も見せない、出さない、感じさせない、まあ、そういった解体工法です。
In fact, the demolition module was the core idea behind this new technology.The module protects the demolition site from weather conditions, making it possible to work any day, rain or shine. Building the module to conform to the shape of the building's outer walls allows the work to be completely hidden from the outside.
テコレップシステムはこのような帽子のようなキャップ構造がかかっています。それを支えているテコレップの柱というのがこのグレーの部分です。まあ、これで、うまく支えながら、しかもそこには油圧ジャッキが仕込まれている。この油圧ジャッキ、まあ仮設柱の国こちらで描いています、まあ、ジャッキダウンする前は重さをここで抱えているんですけれども、まあ、ジャッキダウンするときはこれを下ろして下を、少し、上を浮かして下のこの青い部材をこのように折ってこのように下ろしていくといった具合で、少しずつ下ろしていくといった具合です、まあ、その時にここにあるジャッキとかこの柱とかいうものは全て市販のものを使っているので特注でないので、行くようにでもいろんなところで展開することが可能です。
Another advantage of the pillars is that according to the company's calculations, they can withstand earthquakes of an intensity of 6 or more on the Japanese seismic scale. In addition,The downward movement of the cranes which remove the debris is used to generate electricity. According to calculations, movement of the cranes between the upper floors and the 11th floor produce all the electricity required for the demolition. In the case of the Akasaka Prince Hotel, it shrank at a rate of about 6.4 meters per day. This means that the entire process took 6 months. However, this timetable was based on a 9-to-5 workday.Using rotating shifts, it would have been possible to finish in only 2 months.
まず建物を解体する技術をこれほどその高度な技術を使ってやるかというのはやっぱりこの日本人の気質そして日本の文化というものがやっぱりあった上でその高い技術力があるこの日本の会社であるからこそ、まあ、こういう技術ができるそしてこう単に壊すというようなイメージではなくこう外していくとかですねそういうあの環境に配慮するこのモチベーションの高さというのも、まあ、日本人ならではの考え方としてあの開発されてるんではないかというふうに思います。
It looks like Tokyo, already an ever-changing metropolis, will continue its ongoing transformation in a smarter, more discreet fashion.
While it may not have the instant gratification factor of watching a building implode on itself with the help of some explosives, this new system is pretty impressive. Due to a number of factors, Tokyo didn't get its first modern skyscraper until the late 1960s. Right now, though, there are 47 buildings and structures over 180 meters tall. The tallest building is Midtown Tower, standing at 248 meters.The Tokyo Skytree that we mentioned in today's gadgets segment is the tallest tower in the world at 634 meters. That's it for today's edition of Great Gear. Thanks for joining us. We'll be back next week with more stories about Japanese business and design.